Greetings, we are Alexander. We hope you know who you are. You're playing with a lot of very special energy, and perhaps you call it love energy. It's all around you. But the reality is that you are energy. That energy passes through you, it's all around you. Everything that you are is energy, so you're not just confined within this physical body. You're the air that you breathe. You're the trees around you. You're the chairs you sit in. You're in the room. You're part of that. So you're not separated, even though the body looks like it has physical limits. If you could see the auras around you, you would see that it extends out from your body. So you indeed are a most spectacular being. I'm reminded of a saying that I am everything and I am nothing. And that, if you think about it, really kind of draws you in and say that I am everything and yet I'm not separate. So the personality gets lost out in that. But let me take you back to that energy that is around you. It is what you're connected to. It is the energy that attracts. Now, we could call it love if you're very liberal, but you attract more than just love, the things that you like. You attract to you the things that you don't want. You attract your fears, everything else, whatever you think about, and the emotion that you give it becomes an attraction. So in one sense, it becomes love, but you like to separate it and put it on the shelf and says, this was love and this is hate, or this is fear. The reality is, that is what you have always been. You've always connected with your source by what you think, how you feel, and the emotional amplitude that you give it. So recognize that you're in a very special place. And beyond that, recognize that indeed that you are responsible for everything that happens in your life, and you're responsible for your perception, like whether it's good, bad, ugly, indifferent, it's still your creation. You are that attraction. When you have a thought, the whole of the universe, everything that's around you comes to you and says, yeah, let's play with that. So if you're fearful, then you bring fear. If you're afraid you're going to be attacked, when you're walking outside or in the dark, you're bringing that to you. It's what you have asked the universe for, and the universe always says, okay, let's play with that, if that's what you want. And likewise, love. Remember the first love in your life? All of a sudden you have this boundless energy. And when you walk, you don't touch the street. And you want to dance all the time, or you want to sing, you want to jump up and down. So recognize how intense that love energy is. And when that's shared with someone else, it becomes magnificent, the height of love. And then we have other experiences that perhaps aren't as well. Perhaps that other one doesn't respond to you in kind. And then you have this heartbroken feeling. And most of you have had at least one that had turned you down, probably. At least a handful for me. It's part of growing and part of evolving. So how do you handle that? Notice how you get into that and it begins to evolve, I want to say. So if you're depressed because you've been that down, what you expected, nothing has happened from that, then it keeps going round and round and round in a spiral. As long as that is in your thoughts and as long as you give that energy, that's what you receive. And the whole world could be around you. You could have the most loving, caring person trying to get your attention and nothing affects you. The only thing that you have in your mind is this, oh, woe is me. But that's energy. That's what you are. That's how you create. Everything that you do, every thought that you have is creative. So what you bring into your awareness, the universe has agreed to give you that. So when you have something that you don't like, try something different so that it turns you loose, allows you to do something else, allows you to have another reality. Now, when you're a very young person, a teenager, and you have this beautiful person that you'd like to get to know a lot better, and it doesn't work out, then you have choices. You can go on to the next one. It's like a bee on a flower or a butterfly. Or you can say, that's the end of my world. And it affects you for the rest of your life. It's how you take that energy and how you deal with it. If you stay in that depressed state, then nothing that you would really like to have happen in your life will ever happen, because you have turned it off. You've stopped it before it can ever create. But what if you step out and say, hey, there's a lot of fish in the ocean, or something along that line. What's next for me? Then you find that the whole world turns around, and that one that you thought was indispensable in your life becomes just another experience. Then you grow and you evolve, and that's what this energy is about. It is the very energy that you came in with. It is psychic energy. It is spiritual energy. It is your spiritual connection. When you leave this plane, this is how and what you create, not unlike this. So when you're on the other side and you have this, don't have this physical body to deal with, your thoughts manifest in front of you like visions. The things that you like to project or like to experience are there. If you want to have a gourmet meal, romantic setting, if you wish to have an engagement with an angelic being, it's your thoughts, how much energy you put to it. But when you're without this body, your sight becomes very psychic-like. You have the ability to create those experiences. It's not unlike meditation. If you have meditated and you have had a vision of some beautiful crystal chapel or something like that, or the sun shining and trees blowing in the wind, whatever is your dream, or some beautiful tropic isle like Dennis would tell you about. It is your creation. Is it real? Or is it imagined? You see, you're in this physical body, and the first thing you'll say, if it's not physical, it's not real. But where does the creation come from? In order to have a physical experience, you first have to have imagined it. You have to have brought it in. And when you have that thought that you'd like to have this experience and it begins to happen, it is your creation. And as long as you hold that vision, you create that thing. Again, the things you would love or the things that you would not wish to experience. It's how much energy you give it. You see, you are connected. Everything around you. You are not this individual that just have the thought and it goes away and does not create. You're creating every moment that you're around. You've created this room that you're in. If you were not here, if you did not exist, this would not exist, at least for you. So that is your creation. That is your connection. So what we're trying to get across to you is whatever you want, imagine it. Put some emotion in it. Put some heartfelt energy into it, and you'll find that it indeed will manifest for you. Just as surely as you occupy this body, you occupy those other realms, as you would prefer to call them, that are creative. And when you begin to step into both of those, you will find that those creations are exactly what you have brought forth. Now, my challenge to you is to begin to observe your life. Notice the things that happen around you. They're not accidental. They're not coincidental. They are on purpose. They have been called up by you. You have created by your connection with the whole of the universe. And it gets to be amazing, the things that you will say, hey, I can remember having that thought, and boy, look what's happened. Then you begin to have a little bit of direction in your thoughts. You think, boy, if I can create that, I wonder what would happen if I had this thought. What if I wanted to have this experience? What if I wanted to have that relationship? What if I wanted to have that big house on the hill? of that beautiful automobile. It's all up here. It's imagined. It's not something that you physically work for, especially when you think you don't deserve it or can't afford it. Visions start that creative connection that everyone has. So what would you like in life? What is your greatest desire? Now, I have to tell you, this is all about you. It's not about anyone else. This is what you would desire. You can keep it in your closet. You don't have to share it with anyone. But notice the things you ask for. When you were very young and you decided, hey, maybe I'd like to have a life partner. All of a sudden, that one is there. Now you get a choice. But if you turn down enough of them, you will find that that choice goes away. So recognize how you create. It is your connection. It is who you are. It is the world around you. You are part of everything that exists or ever has existed. When you came into this world the very first time, you were physically not here. You were simply here on a mental level or a conscious level. And you begin to think, what would it be like to have that body? And then you begin to think, well, that body could be a little bit improved if I did this or had that. And you begin to evolve. Then you begin to think, what if I could evolve my mind? What if I could have greater capabilities of knowing what I wanted and create those things? And you see, now you're at a crossroads. You're at a time and space where it's not so much about doing physical things as it is doing mental things, being able to project the things that you want. Before, you thought you were caught in this slave mentality, that you had to work 7/24 for your livelihood. And now you begin to find, maybe that's not so. But notice how your belief affects those creations. How would you wish to be? What is your idea of utopia? What is your idea of heaven? We have to tell you, heaven doesn't exist out there. It exists right here now. You have always been in heaven. It is your perception of your creation that makes it heaven or hell or somewhere in between. You either have angelic wings or you have bat wings. Yes? It's most amazing when I look around the room because I can see energies shift and lights flashing. Sometimes lightning crashes too. So we can tell how you are perceiving those things and how those affect you. And I must say, you're most receptive. I don't know that you believe everything we tell you, but at least you listen. That is a start. So my challenge to you for your next week assignment on this physical plane is simply to observe the things that happen and connect those with your thoughts. And they can be in a moment, in an instant, or they may be something that you have thought of a year ago or something, and now it's just beginning to manifest. But we have to tell you, you are the one that has control over the speed that they manifest or develop. You, for the most part, if you don't know what you're doing, you want to take it step by step, little steps at a time. And if you're a gambler, then you rush in. What is the word? Fools rush in where the angels fear to tread. I think there's a few fearless angels around, but recognize the creative abilities that are here. It's not something that you're going to be taught in school or have been taught, for most of you anyway. You are creators. That's what you're here. That's what you're doing. That's what you have always done and always will be doing. And in the process, you have experiences that allow you to grow and to evolve. So you never have something that doesn't benefit you. The only time it doesn't benefit you is when you decide it doesn't work. It's not for you, or you're a victim. And there's a lot of victims in the world past, but not anymore. You're responsible. Whether you deny it or not, you're going to see that it's going to show up. in every realm of your livelihood and all those around you. Creators. Now, had you ever thought about what if I could create anything and everything I want? Wow. Just by a thought, just by a desire. And we have to tell you, it is the most powerful energy that you'll ever run across. You cannot match it on a physical level. You cannot build it by hand. You cannot construct it on this physical plane without that first imagining, that first attraction to the energy that you are. Recognize that. Now, there is some belief that perhaps you are the highest evolved beings on this earth plane. We're not so sure of that, but we have to tell you, you're probably the most busy, most productive. And that is part of the growing and evolving. Being able to see that you can construct and build and improve and go from one lifetime to another. And we don't want to get into your past lives just now, but we have to tell you, you have come back time and time again. And this is perhaps the first or second time that you've ever had this ability to be creators. Most of the other times you have been absolutely convinced that you have been a victim. Now all of a sudden, here you are, top of the mountain, waiting for things to happen. Did you know that you helped construct the heavens, the stars? Did you know how creative you are? Had you ever imagined that you could simply sit down in meditation or contemplation and create the life that you want and make this earth plane heaven on earth, even with all of the destruction, the terrorism, all of the things that are going on around you? If you do not go there, it's not you. Again, this is all about you. What do you choose? If you wish to be confrontation, then list yourself on some military thing or something and go over and fight until you destroy yourself. And then you can come back again and again and again until you manage to understand that creation is your reality, your world. It doesn't have to involve anyone or anything else. It's all for you. Now, at some point, some being would think, had to set this up. Someone had to have this thought. And you are that energy. You are that collective energy that has set all the rules and regulations of everything around you, how it works. And somewhere you begin to evolve and you think, this is all physical. This is the things I think. And we tell you, it's not the things you think so much as it is the things that you feel, the things that come from here. This is what gives that energy empowerment. This is why you imagine the things you want. So one of the things that your society has not done is to embrace this meditation where you sit quietly and imagine the things you'd like your world to be. Or you sit quietly and you converse with the greater source of this that you call God. And we will assure you, if you ask that source how you create, he will tell you it is by your heart and your imagination. And it's all up to you. There's no restrictions. Whatever you want. The answer is always yes. Always yes. Tomorrow, what will you do? Will you imagine something different in your life, or you keep going on with routine, having it repeat itself over and over again? We tell you, that is a creative effort also, but it is one that you have agreed on. It is what you call your reality. And the reality is, you created it all. How do you like it? How do you love it? Everything is a step up. There is no wasted effort ever. So when you have an experience that doesn't work out for you, you think. Take it in meditation and say, how could it be better? And the answer will come to you. And you change that little bit of heartfelt energy on it and you give it blessings and you say, I love that. Then it begins to change. It begins to be the picture that you would like it to have. If you have been angry at a person and you've had some sort of a difference of opinion, take it in meditation and see what happens. Ask how you could improve that. And the next thing you'll know, you'll have that person hugging you because that is what you have felt. One person only is the creator of your world. And you know who it is. Only you. So if you have had parents that have been a little rough on you, we have to tell you, you asked for that. On some level, that was part of your experiences. You either had to grow from that or feel like you're a victim. There are certain ones of you, including this person that is here, that most times does better with criticism than praise. If somebody tells this one he can't do this or can't do that, that's like a challenge. So the very next thing that he wants to do is to prove to himself that indeed it's possible. When this was first started playing with music, he was told, don't quit your day job. Good advice. But it also was kind of an energy to say, well, apparently it's not where it needs to be, or it's not where I would need it to be. So let's play with it and then see. It is kind of like that old saying, how do you get to Carnegie Hall? Practice, practice, practice. You do it enough. You love what you're doing and it begins to grow and to evolve, and that's how you are. When you are young, you're easily frustrated when things don't work out exactly as you had planned on this physical level. But we have to tell you, the things that you experienced early on are exactly the things that you need to direct your life so that you may have the experiences that you wish, that you may direct those. You are never in control. You're always the director. The universe will send you everything you want, but you are the one that has to direct it. But if you try to control it and say, it has to happen this way, we will assure you that it will happen exactly the opposite. That is part of your growing and evolving. That is part of your awareness. That is part of your ability to have heartfelt creations. Nice and easy. Now, when you reach that point, I've recognized that indeed you're the creator. It's kind of like going to a good movie. You watch everything that you create and you have this thought in the next week or so it comes up before you. Or you have this thought, I'd like to know that person better the next week. You have that opportunity. Your creations. How you would like to deal with the rest of the world. But it is mostly about you. You are the one that puts that energy forth. You've asked the whole of the universe, simply by a thought, to create with you. You have heard that word, co-creators? This is it. This is you, the director. Everything that you are, that stands around you, is your connection, your attraction. It is what's being brought to you. Not just once or twice, but every moment, every thought is creative, always and ever, and it has always been that way. You are the one that directs it, how you wish to spend your life. And if you can get it on the track that you want it, boy, you become creators, and you find the joy, and you find indeed this is heaven. It is not some hellish imprisonment. You have not been sent here to be punished for some wrongdoing. Jesus didn't die on the cross for you. They like that one. Makes you feel guilty, you see. Jesus died to show you the way. It wasn't because you were a sinner. It was because you were a creator. And he's saying, Look at how you changed your creations. Look at what I did. Look at the mistakes that I made. I made those for you. What is your perception? You've had many great teachers that have come along. So who is your main teacher? Perhaps it is some musician, some singer. Perhaps someone sings a song like this one from the islands have sang to you. Perhaps it shifted your awareness just a little, just enough to say, hey, I'd like to create something along that way. Perhaps it inspired you to sing a little. Nobody is perfect, but you're all reaching for perfection. You're all evolving. If you were perfect, you probably wouldn't be here. So we are all imperfect angels, trying to fly, crashing occasionally. But we heal ourselves and get up and we go again. So recognize that this is perhaps the most creative heaven that you can ever be in. You are the one that is the creator. So we would say to you, thank you for allowing me to speak of love, speak of the energy that you are, make you aware of your surroundings, and assure you that you indeed are the creator. You are the most beautiful, creative creature that you have ever known or ever will know, much beyond this that is Jesus or any others that have been here. They came of their own accord. You are here in this time and space because this is where you have decided to be. This is where you're growing and where you're evolving. This is your church, and this is not Monday morning. So you see, you're in good shape. This is Sunday. This is full time. So your Monday morning church that is empty and vacant without the energies, you would think. You have it within you to be created. We bless you. We're Alexander.